What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Double Take's Offseason Report. Now, the Raptors definitely exceeded expectations last season, as they were still a very respectable team, even without Kawhi. You could tell going into the playoffs that they had a lot of confidence. But now they kind of find themselves in a very similar position that they were in before the big Kawhi signing, as a decent team that doesn't really have the pieces to get over the hump. Now, they're known to be very much interested in Giannis in 2021, but what could be done this offseason to help improve the team? The Raptors have a lot of free agents going into this offseason, including Fred VanVleet, Marc Gasol, and Serge Ibaka. The most pressing of these is obviously VanVleet, who's emerged into a rising star in the last couple of seasons. What's tricky about him, though, is that he's one of the few marquee free agents this offseason. And though the Raptors could try to match any team that comes forward, they most likely want to keep some extra cap space for the impending 2021 offseason. In my opinion, though, the Raptors should do everything they can to try to keep this guy. His improvement is immensely impressive, and it's unlikely that any big free agent will want to deal with the sheer cold of Toronto if they weren't a competitive team next year. As for Mark and Serge, they both made over $23 million last year, and unless they take a big pay cut to stay in Toronto, it would be in their best interest to let one of them walk. When Serge was healthy last year, he honestly put up some good numbers. Look for the Raptors to try to sign him again, unless he gets an insane offer that he can't refuse. Now, like I said before, the Raptors are eyeing guys available after the 2021 season, but there are some free agents available this year that could really help improve the team without breaking the bank. The Raptors were stellar defensively last year, but it wouldn't hurt if they had some more consistent firepower. Joe Harris could be a good option, as the Nets will have to alleviate some of their luxury tax woes that are on the horizon. Even Boogie Cousins could be a good gamble. He has been on and off the court for a while, but that also means that he'll be a bargain if he's anywhere close to the player he was a couple years ago. And if you have to let Ibaka or Gasol go, he could have a real opportunity to prove himself. Free agents aside, the Raptors have some things to iron out before the next season starts. First of all, Pascal Siakam's disappearing act against the Celtics in the playoffs was certainly alarming. He was only the player we knew him to be in Game 4 of that series, as Kyle Lowry seemed to be more of the alpha. Now, Lowry overperforming isn't a problem, but Siakam has got to be a little bit more consistent if they want to attract a big name in 2021. He's still improving dramatically, and he's only 26, but if he wants to take that next step as a bona fide superstar, he'll need to develop his jumper and handles to more effectively create his own shot. Don't get me wrong, I'm pretty confident that he's going to have a monster year this coming season. Lastly, the Raptors will miss Nate Bjorkgren. The now Pacers head coach played a big role in the Raptors' defensive identity and mindset. I don't think it's going to be noticed in the win column, but he was a team favorite and will bring a similar intensity in Indiana. With all due respect to the Raptors, they probably won't be considered a title contender by most going into next season. But hey, the East still isn't great, and we've been wrong about this team in the past, a team that always genuinely believes that they have a shot at winning it all.